somewhat dusta, there is other addictions or wrong company, or he is a womanizer, whatever may be the problem with the person, or apart from his characters, even his financial crisis, even his professional status, even his knowledge, physical health, longevity, family status, mother-in-law, father-in-law, brother-in-law, all people, there all dimensions of developments of work can be properly governed by the Mangala Sutra, provided all samskaras have been very properly, systematically organized. So that is the greatness of marriage. In Upanayana also, they are finishing the Upanayana in half a day or one day. See, for example, 10 days we have been carrying the child. 10 days we have been holding the child for the fullest maturity. Likewise, 3 days or one day, according to this Kali, Kala or the present time, whatever you may brand it, you must take the fullest opportunity. That is Twara. You have to finish it within half an hour. Can you say the same thing to whenever we conducted Vishwashanti Homa, somebody used to say, you have to finish it within 1 hour, they have to go for lunch. Let them go, we cannot finish it. Can you say the same thing to a surgeon? You have entrusted your father or husband to surgeon. Can you say like that? I want to go to office or somebody is coming to meet, so leave my father before. So we cannot say like that. It is also surgery. It is also subtler than surgery. It is also doing something for your internal salubrity. So you have to wait for that. Upanayana also, the Danda Grihana is there, Munji Grihana is there, Ajina Grihana is there, then Yajnopavita Dharana is there, then Chuda Grihana is there, Keshanta Samskara is there, then Vidyabhyasa, Omkarabhyasa is there, then Vedarambhabhyasa is there. So in knowledge, in Upanayana, each and everything is so significant. A person is standing on a stone, that is known as Ashmarohana, and touching it with Hridaya. I am doing with commitment. I should not be peripheral, it should not be ephemeral, or it should not be prevaricated or perfunctory. Whatever I do here, with the power of mantra, because human beings, we know that we are deficient. We don't do things wholeheartedly, number one. We don't do things continuously. Third thing, we don't do things with the proper aim. Fourth thing, we do things with all the other possible mistakes, errors, and all other prohibited things. These four things are the natural unavoidabilities of human beings. So, in order to create the power of mantra to come for support, because of our deficient nature, the Hridaya Sparsha is being done both in the marriage, also in Upanayana. Upanayana is a divine marriage, communion of the Jivatma with the Brahman, and replication to create progeny for that Brahmopadesha and Jnana. We are making the Vivaha Samskara. So Vivaha is mundane model for a divine communion. That is a divine model for this mundane communion. Upanayana and Vivaha both are divine communion. So this Upanayana Samskara is also done with lot of things. Now nobody is doing. At the time of marriage, I have been seeing a lot of people wearing the Jagdupavita. There are three people having their Upavita. Which is their Upavita? One, just wearing Upavita with no mantra or upasana. Number two, not wearing it at all. Number three, wearing it at the time of marriage and not even at the time of marriage. These are all the people that we see in the society. So persons without these qualifications, how they are going to do that? The final thing is antiyakti. Even death, Shastra says that unless you are properly cremated, three possibilities are there. The vasanas, that is whatever the vasanaseshas, the impulses, imprints and the residues and the connectivity with this body will not be totally uprooted unless it is successfully ceremonially cremated. We can cremate anybody. A lot of incidents are there, a Gobra incident is there, lot of people are being burned, lot of people are being buried, innumerable things are done in the name of atrocities. But ceremonially it should be done. Unless it is done, three problems. One, your residue with this body will become incomplete, by which you have to come back or you will be restless. Number one, Ashanta or Paryataka. Paryataka is will be wandering here and there. Ashanta is you won't have the tranquility to get a new tag for a new body and to reside inside a new body for a new life. And second thing, unless you are properly cremated, your lineage cannot be adjoined with your predecessors, so that you will be a proper tool to receive the tarpana and any other spiritual nourishment given by your successors. Your successors are going to offer you the tarpana and various other things. If you want to receive those things and get that nourishment also for your prosperity and promotion in your physical status, unless you are properly cremated, you cannot join the lineage of the Pitrus, the second thing. Number three, if you are not properly cremated, Acharadi, Yamadi, Dhumadi and Bhumadi Marga will be Sanskrit. Coming here is Bhumadi, going to heavenly planets is Dhumadi, getting into Yatana Sharira and suffering, that is known as Yamadi. going for salvation or liberation is known as archaradi. A person's promotion or repatriation or inclusion in the lineage of the forefathers and get the spiritual nourishment sanctioned from successors in the form of daily rites or monthly rites will be possible only by proper cremation. So Shastra says that even after death, even at the time of death, we have to do a lot of things. The science is known as eschatology. Eschatology is the science, E-S-C-H-A-T-O-L-O-G-Y. Eschatology is a divine science that deals with proper type of cremation, taking transmigration, getting into liberation, heavenly planets, hellish planets, different types of bodies, the pitrus, their lineage, connectivity, why to give tarpana, everything is discussed in eschatology. So what we want here to know is, we are having innumerable connectivity, like Dahana Samskara, we have Sapindi Karana, we have Asaucha, we have Udaka Samskara. The person dies with water, then he is purified. His connectivity is purified. Even if your father dies, the connectivity of the father with the son, that collapses by his death. But till the son lives, survives, his connectivity with the father, that rests. That continues to exist. So he has to do tarpana. Somebody asks, who is receiving the tarpana? If tarpana is to be given, certainly there should be somebody to receive the tarpana. That person, he gets new birth and he is accommodated in a new body, and then he is going to receive tarpana and all of these things. It is told in the Shastra that this tarpana reaches Swadha. Swadha is the family of Pitru Devatas who are residing in the Pitru Lokas. Through these subtle channels, they reach the Pitru Devatas and granted as divine wishes through this lineage. So whatever we get, we are seeing somewhere, we are thinking two things. Unexpectedly, I got that opportunity. I don't know how, but I unexpectedly or surprisingly, I escaped in that danger. How it occurs? It occurs only by the greatest blessings of our Pitrus. So in each and every walk of life, whatever the development we see, whatever the advancement we see, whatever the protection, prevention and prosperities that we enjoy, everything, one third of the grant goes to the munificence of our ancestors. So Pitrus are silently doing lot of beneficial showers by which we are getting all our benefits in our life. So tarpana should be given to all of the people, and eschatology is a special science which is detected for that purpose, and Sapindi Karana is an access for that. After a person dies, Udaka Karana or Udaka Shanti or Udaka Kriya is done. By which the person is purified and his total detachment. Death is, see, he used to call it in science as blood death and brain death. Likewise, if a person is cremated, the tangible connectivity is removed. But unless the Udaka Shanti or Udaka Kriya is done, the subtle connectivity is not removed. So Udaka Kriya. Second thing is, after that, there is Asti Sankalana. We have to collect that Asti and put it in holy water, which most of the people we do. Then we are having Asaucha. We have to observe that. Why foreigners are not allowed inside the temples? Why scheduled caste and scheduled tribe people, most of the people are not allowed inside the temple? Because our Shastras observe three restrictions. One is Sutaka, the subtle impact of some sort of evil forces which occur at the time of birth is known as Sutaka. When somebody is born, then there is an Asaucha. There is a prohibitive demarcation. That is Sutaka. Second thing, if somebody dies, that is a prohibitive demarcation. That is known as Mrutaka. Third thing is Rajas. We consider that the menstrual discharge as something negative and something anti-spiritual, so that for that particular year, they are refrained from three things. One is Puja, second is Paka, third is Shayana. That ladies, they are refrained from these activities. So, Westerners, they don't believe this thing at all. If somebody dies and if they are cremated, it is over. There is no Asaucha, there is no continuity. Somebody is born, that is something which is celebratable. And why to observe and lot of things, lot of restrictions, why they have not been made. And this menstrual discharge, another thing is just a biological excretion, like a urine and excreta, and there is nothing speciality in that, so we need not do that. So this type of revolutionary ideas are with people. Westerners are revolutionaries, and the so-called downtrodden members of the society, they are nescient. So these people, they are not allowed because they don't have the strong practices of these things. Moreover, they eat beef also, which we worship the same cow, we are eating the beef. So these four reasons are the reasons by which Panchamas, Patitas, Chantadas, Brattas and Blechas, these five people are not allowed to Yajnashala and Devalayas. If we are not doing that, having a lot of divine names, having puja rooms, having spiritual belief and practicing pilgrimage and other things, if we are also doing the same thing, what is the difference between a Blecha and Saicha? So we have to also observe all these things. So by burning, for example, for